We have already discussed in the last lecture about the one-dimensional wave equation and general solution. The one-dimensional wave equation was UTT minus C square mu xx equal to 0. And we have obtained its general solution, u of x t equal to f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct, where f and g are twice continuously differentiable arbitrary functions. Okay, so coming into the functions f and g, f and g are real valued functions. So for a function for a fixed time t naught, what about the graphs of f of x plus ct and g of x minus ct? Actually, the graph of g of x and graph of g of x minus ct naught, for a fixed t naught, the graph of g of x and graph of g of x minus ct naught are will have same shape, but it is g of x minus ct naught. The graph of x minus ct is not actually the graph of g of x which is shifted to right by a distance ct naught. That is, if the graph of g of x is this, then this is the graph of g of x, but this is x. Then the graph of g of x minus ct naught, where t naught is a fixed quantity, so ct naught is also a fixed quantity. So g of x minus ct naught, the graph of g of x minus ct naught is actually is same as g of x, but it is shifted to the length, shifted to right of by a distance or by a length ct naught. So this is the length ct naught. Okay, so this is the graph of g of x and this is the graph of g of x minus ct naught, right? So the graph of g of x minus ct naught has the same shape as the graph of the function g of x, but it is shifted to the right by a distance ct naught, where t naught is fixed. So the function g of x t represents a wave moving to the right side with velocity c. Okay, so g of x t is a wave moving to the right with velocity c. So this g of x t is called a forward wave. This g of x t is called a forward wave. Okay, similarly we can say that what about f of x plus ct? For this fixed t naught, f of x plus ct naught has the graph of f of x plus ct naught has the same shape that of f of x, but it is shifted to the left. Okay, shifted to the left with by a distance ct naught. Okay, so similarly we can say that f of x plus ct is a wave traveling to the left with the same speed c. So we obtained that is f of x t is called a backward wave. F of x t is called a backward wave. Okay, so here we can say that c as the wave speed. Okay, c is the wave speed. So in the solution of the wave equation, we have the solution u of x t equal to f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct. Here g of x minus ct is a forward wave, that is, this function is moving to the right side and this f of x minus ct is moving to the left side. Okay, with the same speed c. Clear? For a fixed t naught. Okay, so for a fixed t naught, this will be actually f is a function of x comma t, but for a fixed t naught, this will be a function of x only, and g is also a function of becomes a function of x only. So in that case, it will the solution is actually a combination of two waves. One is forward wave and the other is backward wave. That is, this is passes to the right with a speed c, and the f is passes to the left with the same speed c. Okay, now So we have the this is that, that means u of x t equal to f of x plus c t plus g of x minus c t gives the, that any solution of the wave equation is the sum of two such traveling waves. That is in the such traveling waves with the opposite direction traveling actually. Okay. So now for any two real piecewise continuous function. Suppose we have the solution u equal to f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct. If these two functions f and g are two real piecewise continuous functions, okay, that means in the solution we have the solution u equal to f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct. Now for any two real piecewise continuous functions f and g, u equal to f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct gives a piecewise continuous function u. Okay, this gives a piecewise continuous function u, that is a superposition of this f and g. Okay, that means if f and g are any two real piecewise continuous functions, that is if it is if these functions are piecewise continuous functions, then use u is also a piecewise continuous functions, which will be a superposition position of this f and g. Okay, that means where f is a forward backward wave and g is a forward wave traveling in opposite direction. Okay, with the same speed c. So in that case, if f and g are piecewise continuous functions, we can say satisfying this condition, that is satisfying this condition means this is the solution of the wave equation, then we call we can call the function u as a generalized solution. Okay, generalized solution of the wave equation. That means in the solution u of x t equal to f of x plus c t plus g of x minus c t, if f and g are piecewise continuous functions, then we can say the function u is a generalized solution of the wave equation. Generalized solution of the wave equation. Okay, that means if these waves f and g are piecewise continuous functions, real piecewise continuous functions, then we can say that u is a generalized solution of the wave equation. Clear? Now. Now coming into the general solution u of x t equal to f of x plus c t plus g of x minus c t. Now consider the x t plane. X t plane means the characteristics. Okay, so coming to the characteristics of this wave equation. So the families of lines x plus c t equal to a constant, x minus c t equal to a constant, another constant, are called the characteristics of the wave equation. Okay, so the characteristics of the wave equation are x plus ct equal to a constant and x minus ct equal to a constant. So these are the characteristics of the wave equation. Okay. Now for the wave equation, so therefore the wave equation the characteristics are straight lines in the xt plane with the slopes plus or minus 1 by c, because we have the characteristics x plus ct equal to a constant. So from this x plus ct equal to some constant c1 implies t equal to c1 minus x, okay, by c, right? So from this, the slope is dt by dx is equal to minus 1 by c. Similarly, from this we get x minus ct equal to some constant c2, so we have t equal to x minus c2 divided by c, so dt by dx is equal to d1 by c. So these slopes are given by 1 by c or minus 1 by c. So for the wave equation, the characteristics are straight lines in the xt plane with the slopes plus or minus 1 by c. For this, the slope is minus 1 by c, and for this, top is 1 by c. Clear? Now, at a fixed time t naught, assume that u is a smooth function except at one point x naught t naught. Okay. Suppose we have this is the xt plane, this is x and this is t. Suppose we have this is the point x naught t naught. Okay. Suppose at this point the function u is not smooth. Okay. So assume that u is a smooth function except at this point x naught t naught. Now that means f is not smooth at x naught plus t naught, or g is not smooth at x naught minus c t naught, or both. That means since we have u is equal to f of x plus c t plus g of x minus c t. This is the general solution. So we are assumed that at the point t naught, u is not smooth. U is not smooth means this f plus g is not smooth. So that means either f is not smooth at the point x naught t naught. That is at the point x naught t naught, x naught t naught, or g is not smooth at the point x naught t naught, or both. That means f is not smooth at x naught t naught and g is not smooth, or f and g are not smooth at the point x naught t naught. Okay. So we are assuming such a condition. Now to find the characteristics passing through the x naught t naught. Okay. So we have the characteristics are given by x plus ct equal to some constant c1 and x minus ct equal to some constant c2. So to find the characteristics passing through this point x naught t naught. So at x naught t naught we have from this x naught plus ct naught equal to c1 and x naught minus ct naught is equal to c2. So we will get the value of c1 and c2 as this. So replacing these values in the characteristics, we get x plus ct equal to x naught plus ct naught and x minus ct equal to x naught minus ct naught. So this passing through x naught t naught are x naught plus ct naught and x minus ct equal to x naught minus ct naught. So these are straight lines, we know. So this is actually we'll write like this. So for this is x and this is t. So suppose this is the point x naught t naught. So it will be like this. Okay. Let this point be x naught t naught. So this point is x naught, this is x naught, and this is t naught, right? So this point will be x naught plus c t naught, and this point will be x naught minus c t naught, because these are the characteristics. This is actually this characteristics is x plus ct equal to x naught plus ct naught, and this is the characteristics x minus ct is equal to x naught minus ct naught. So when t naught equal, and this is t, this is the point t. So when t equal 0 from this, okay, when t equal 0 we have x equal x naught plus ct naught. So this point will be x naught plus ct naught, and from this we get when t equal 0 x equal to x naught minus ct naught. So this characteristics touches the x axis at the point x naught minus ct naught, and this characteristic touches the x axis at x naught plus ct naught. Okay. So we assumed that at this point u is not smooth. At this point, for a fixed t naught, we are assuming that the function u is actually in the next axis. So u is, we are assuming at this point u is not smooth except at the point x naught t naught. Okay. So now for any time t1 not equal to t0, that is for any time t1 not equal to t0, that is for any time lies in this except at t0, the solution u is smooth except at one or two points x plus or x minus. That satisfies this, that is x plus ct1 is equal to x0 plus ct0, x minus ct1 is equal to x0 minus ct0. It is because either f is not smooth at the point x0, t0, or g is not smooth at the point x0, c0, or both f or f and g are not smooth at the point x0, t0. That is, the singularities are of the solution of the wave equation are traveling only along the characteristics. That is, singularities means the points at which u is small, not smooth. Okay. So that the singularities of the from this we get the singularities of the solution of the wave equation are traveling along only traveling only along the characteristics. Okay. So the singularities will be traveling along these characteristics. Okay. That is the case here. Now next we can discuss an example. Let u of x t be a solution of the wave equation utt minus e square ni ux x equal to 0, which is defined in the wall plane. Assume that u is a constant on the line x equal to 2 plus ct. Then we have to prove that ut plus c ux equal to 0. So we are given that u is the solution of the wave equation utt minus e square to ux x equals 0, and we have given a condition, that is on the line x equal to 2 plus ct u is a constant. Okay, now we have to prove that this condition, that is ut plus c ux equal to 0. So we have the solution u. Our general solution of this wave equation is given by u of x t is equal to f of x plus c t plus g of x minus c t. Okay, now applying this condition, we are given the condition that u is a constant along the line x equal to 2 plus c t. Okay, that means we are given that when x equal to 2 plus ct, u is a constant. That is, the condition is u of 2 plus ct comma t equal to a constant, some c1, where c1 is a constant. That is, we are given that u is a constant on the line x equal to 2 plus ct. That is, when x equal to 2 plus ct, u is a constant. So, we are replacing x by 2 plus ct and u by c1. So the condition is u of 2 plus ct comma t equal to c1. So applying this condition to our solution 1, we'll get f of x plus ct, that is 2 plus ct plus ct plus g of 2 plus ct minus ct equal to u. U is c1 here. Okay. That is f of 2 plus 2 ct plus g of 2 equal to c1, where c1 is a constant, also g of 2 is also a constant. So we can write f of 2 plus ct equal to another constant c2, where c2 equal to c1 minus g of 2. Okay, that means if we set this is a function of t only. So if we set some s is equal to 2 plus 2 ct, we will get what? F of s is equal to a constant. So we got f is a constant. Okay. Therefore the solution is, therefore the solution of the wave equation is, one implies u of xt is equal to f of xt, f of x plus ct plus g of x minus ct. We obtain f of f is a constant, so some constant c2 plus g of x minus ct. Okay, so now we have to prove this condition ut plus c ux equal to 0. So This is about the solution now, u of x t equal to c2 plus g of x minus ct, which satisfies this condition also. Okay. So, to verify this, we have to find ut and ux. So, from this solution, we get ut is equal to derivative of this with respect to t. So, this is nothing but g dash of x minus ct into derivative of x minus ct with respect to t, that is minus c. That is minus c into g dash of x minus ct. And ux is equal to partial derivative of u with respect to x. So here is c2 a constant. So g dash x plus, so x minus ct into derivative of c x minus ct with respect to x, which is 1. Okay. So we need to verify this ut plus c ux, c ux. Okay. Therefore, ut plus c ux is equal to 0, because ut equal to this and c, we get minus c g dash of x minus ct plus c into ux is g dash of x minus ct, which is nothing but